Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to this edition of Programming Wizards. Today we shall look at something interesting. We're going to see how to use a grid view. Remember in the last tutorial we used a grid view with text only. Okay, we used how to make a grid view with text but also with the search functionality in the previous tutorial. And in this tutorial we're going to see how to make a grid view with images. Okay, for this one it shall be images only. And we shall also see how to capture the events. Guys, this is what I'm talking about. Now take note, if I come click this one right here, you can see image 0, okay, then image 1. Now we can differentiate, we can capture the event for all the items in our grid view. Okay, so guys, we're going to see how to make a grid view. We shall be using BaseAdapter. Now guys, welcome, we get started. So ladies, welcome once more. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once more. Now this is what we're going to do. Right now you can see I've already created my class right here, the main activity class. Okay, so the next class that we're going to do, I shall need you to create an adapter class. Okay, now the adapter is what shall adapt our images to our grid view. So please just come right here and create that an adapter class. Okay, and in fact even before that one, I shall also require you to add a couple of images that we shall use to display. So please, if you want to add images, just copy them from your disk, then add them to in your rest drawable folder. Now you can see these are my images right here. Okay, you can see I have plenty of them. So we shall be referencing them from here. If you want to reference them from a URL or something, you can also do the same. But this one shall be loading them locally. Guys, that's it. Now we shall move on. Let's come and start with the adapter. As we've said, this class shall extend, just add there, extends BaseAdapter. So the adapter class, this is what shall draw our images inside our grid view. I mean, so this one extends a BaseAdapter. Okay, now once we've done that one, it shall require us to add some methods that we shall be overriding. Now you can see get count, then get item, then get id. But before that one, let's come and create a constructor. So just come right here and add a constructor right there. Inside this our constructor, in fact I shall in fact even before our constructor, let's just go on top right here and create two objects. The first one shall be the context object, we just declare them. Then you shall also have an integer array, okay, that shall contain our images. So just have them right there. Now once we've done so, these are the two things that we shall pass inside our constructor. Our constructor, when somebody initializes this our adapter class, it shall be required to pass the context, okay, the context, and then it shall also be required to pass the an integer array, which of course shall actually be the one containing the images. So if you instantiate this class, there shall be a must. So that's it. Let's come here and just say this dot c equal to c, then this dot images equal to images. Guess that's it. That's our context and our images. Now the next thing that we're going to do, okay, this is a get count. Now the get count, this one actually shall return the count of the total number of items. Okay, remember this is a grid view, so the total number of items are contained in that grid view. In our case actually the total number of images, because it is the images that we want to display. So if we want to get the total number of images, of course we just get images.length, which of course images is an array. Then I get this one right here, this one is the position. No, get item. If we want an item, of course this is an array, we just pass the position as the index. It shall return for us the particular item. Now guys, let's come to this get view method. This one actually, just to make them more readable, this is the position, this is the convert view, then this is the parent, the view group. So what we're going to do right here is very simple. Remember, we want to display images, so the first thing, we have to create an image view that shall be used to display our images inside our grid view. So I'll call just main, then we're just going to instantiate it equal to new image. we shall be required to pass their context, we pass their C. This does it, that's the image object that shall display our images. Okay. Now the next thing that we're going to do, we're just going to set an image to this particular image view. So just come here and set image. No, that is simple. Image, that we just call it set image resource method. So set image resource shall of course requires to pass the particular image, and then if we want to get our image, of course we have an array of images, then we also have the index right here. So we just pass that one. That one shall populate our grid view dynamically with different images. Now after that one, probably we shall now want to just have some give it some properties. Now the first property that we want is the scale type that we want to set to our image view. Remember, this is an image view, so just come image dot set scale type, then just write have there image view. What is this image view? Let me just copy this one right here. So image view dot scale type. Okay, now for our scale type, we're going to pass the center crop. So just have the image view dot scale type dot center crop. Now that's it. The next one property that probably that you shall want to know is to set the layout params for our image view. Remember, this is an image view, so just come and set image view dot set layout params. It is right here. Then a new grid view dot layout params, whatever I typed. So now guys, for me my params, I shall they are pass 115 by 115. Okay, actually the size for my images, remember they shall be displayed in my image, the parameters for my image. Okay, now that is it. So what we're going to return here of course is just that image. Of course it is only an image that we want to display, so we don't have to create any other view. Guys, that's it. That's it. We shall only return that image view. So that's our base adapter class. That's our adapter class. Now the next thing, we shall now come to our main class, main activity class. So what we're going to do here is very simple. Of course, by the for your property, let's just come for our XML layout file right here. Now you can see right here I've just dragged a grid view. You can just drag. It's just a simple grid view. Now the only changes that I've made is these two changes. I've just given it some horizontal and vertical spacing. If you don't give it, actually it shall still show them, but it won't give them enough padding. Okay, so we've just given them some spacing between them so that it makes it nicer. Now that's it. The next thing, let's just come right here and instantiate our grid view object. So just come and say grid view. I'll call mine GV. So the next thing that we shall also need is our images. So we are going to create an array of integer array that shall contain our images. So guys, very first I'll pause the video and type all my images right here. So you can see these are my images. You can see all of them right here. Actually I had shown you these ones, so I've just typed them one by one right there. So these are the images that shall act as our data source. Now guys, the next thing that we're going to do, we're going to initialize our grid view. So just come and say grid view equal to find view by r.id dot grid view 1. Then of course we shall cast this one to grid view. Okay, then once we've done that one, remember most of the job we've done inside our adapter. So right here we shall now come and instantiate our adapter class. Actually I called it adapter. So we're going to create adapter, and just call it adapter equal to new adapter. It shall require to pass the context, in this case which is this, then the images of course, which is the integer array. That's it. The next thing, we're just going to set our adapter to our grid view. So call grid view to set adapter, then we pass adapter right there. That's it. In fact, if we run it right now, we shall be able to display our images. The only thing guys remaining, what about if we want to capture the events? Okay, the on click listeners or and whatever. Now just come and say jv dot set on item click listener. So and then a new adapter view dot on item click listener. So you shall have to import this one and then add an implemented method. So this one I'll just call av, this one I'll just call v, then this one is the position, okay, and then this one is the id. Remember now adapter view, for example, we were calling the get id and get item id and whatever. So that's it, guys. This is our stuff. Now what we're going to do here, of course, is just to display the position of that particular item, the particular image, just to show how to capture the events in a grid view. So just come and say toast.makeText, then for the get application context, then right here you just want to display something like image and then plus position, okay. Then of course right here toast dot length short, then dot show dot show. And guys, that's our program. No, I think we are through. I don't see if we have any other thing. Of course, we've created our adapter class, so we've set our adapter, we've handled our on click listener. That's it, guys. Let's run the project and have a look. And ladies and gentlemen, here's our program. Now you can see right here, I've run mine in my BlueStacks app player. Now you can see if I come, I click a single item, you can see image 0, okay, image 1, then image 2. Of course, if I come to this last image, you can see image 11. So guys, that's it. This is how we display images, okay, in our grid view. I hope you've learned something. Please, if you have, just subscribe to this channel. You shall continue receiving tutorials like these ones. You can also view all the Android tutorials, okay. You can like this video, you can share it with friends and family. Leave a comment down below, would like to hear from you guys. And please take care. I shall catch you in the next tutorial.